It was the conspiracy, political conspiracy, to make the case as a false encounter case. This conspiracy involved the most powerful men of this country. It was the version of certain greedy top senior most officers of the CBI who, for post-retirement allurement, became the pawn in the hands of those most powerful politicians of the country. The UPA was ruling that time, knowing fully well that they were terrorists, they have come for carrying out a major terrorist act which could have resulted in massive casualties and which would have resulted in total destabilization of the state. Did any of the witnesses said that they were not terrorists? Has CBI charge sheet mentions that they were not terrorists? They should have said. Say every institution of the state was manipulated for this political hatchet job. They were to be used and threatened and pressurized to implicate Mr. Narendra Modi. See, it was not Rajinder Kumar or the police officers of Gujarat who were the target. They were to be used and threatened and pressurized to implicate Mr. Narendra Modi. The UPA, immediately after coming to power, they wanted to fix Gujarat. And police was demoralizing, even in the Sohrabuddin case. Sohrabuddin was who? A person from whom hundreds of AK-47 rifles are recovered. After they first wanted to fix this, the politicians in Gujarat, political politicians in Gujarat, opponent of the then rural power in Gujarat, in Ishrat Jahan case, but when the MHA filed the affidavit, then for some time they thought that there is a setback which I have shown to you. Then they went to Sohrabuddin case. Then again, Sohrabuddin case, they can reach up to one point. Then they went, they could not reach the real man. So then they again fallen back on the Ishrat Jahan case. Then this is how I was given motivations, I was given threats, I was given motivations that you will be given this job, post-retirement. But, and at that time nobody came to my support except sympathy from some of my supporters, some of the officers, of the professional officers. So nobody came to my support. I was waging a lone battle against the most powerful man. But I didn't bow to the pressure because I can't give a false evidence. My conscience did not align. They wanted only two lines from me, that you give this, say these two lines and you would be given this post or that post. There was a meeting in the house of a minister of state in the then government, where a cabinet minister was present, a very powerful politician was present. They are the first number two man of the CBI was called and asked to fix us. And this cabinet minister, he said, arrest Rajinder Kumar, take his remand, police remand for 5-7 days, give him a good beating, and he will take the name of those politicians who were their opponents.
Whom they Modi.
Yes, this minister has been representing the cases of the associates of Dawood Ibrahim in the past. When the democracy was subverted by, in this manner, when a politician who could have been the, who was a prime challenge to the ruling party, if they wanted to carry out a investigative encounter of that gentleman and send him to the gallows, where was the, this, all these people? This is a case on record where this conspiracy can be proved. Hadley has also made one thing very important, very credible. He said this conspiracy started in 2006. In fact, if you see, from 2004, this targeting was done. LET has tasked its cadres, two cadres in India, to start working for targeting Mr. Bal Thackeray, Mr. Alka Advani, Mr. Narendra Modi, Mr. Ashok Singhal and Mr. Praveen Togadia. Cadres in India told that ki sahab Gujarat mein to election voting ho jayegi 20 tarikh ko, uske baad wo log honge nahi, kya kare hain, aap aadmi aur saman bhejiye. Aadmi aur saman nahi aaya 20 tarikh ko, jab tak voting bhi ho gayi to unhone bola ki jitne bhi campaigner hain ye sab chale gaye Gujarat se bahar. So then they said, okay, when can be the best opportunity? The best opportunity, they thought that it will be 13th May when the results would be out. The general perception was the NDA would win. Mr. Advani and Mr. Modi would come to Delhi, come to Ahmedabad, and they will be together in a victory procession, and then they should be targeted. But for unfortunately, for LET, they could not send the cadre even on 13th of May. You asked me a question about the demoralization in the security agencies. Let me tell you, 170 people who have died in Mumbai terror blast would not have died if this political stupidity would not have been started political for political purposes. The security agencies were not victimized for this thing.